Recently, I drove out to a First Nations community just west of Edmonton and found that all the entrances to the community were barricaded, except one where one could go in or out, but you had to check first of all with the security guards there. The reason, of course, is to keep everyone in the community safe and well and to avoid the entrance of the COVID virus. That experience and that situation really relates to the gospel today, to the readings today, where we are asked to believe in Jesus as the gate, as the shepherd, to listen to his voice, so as to live in his kingdom of abundant life. It's interesting, in the gospel, Jesus speaks of community as well. He calls it the sheepfold. And I think he's speaking about the kingdom of God, the community of life that God wants to share with us. And he calls that the abundant life. However, to enter into that community, he is the gate. So faith in him as the good shepherd is the way to enter into his kingdom of abundant life in this life, I think, not just in the next life. So as a shepherd, we must listen to his voice, do his will, and follow him if we want to enter into that kingdom. And that's important because there are many other voices out there. Jesus speaks of those voices as thieves and bandits. And we know that Satan is out to steal and kill and lie and destroy. Some of those voices out there are the voices of temptation, that money, fame, and power is what is going to make us happy, that we can get over attached to them and find meaning there. Another voice out there is one that puts us down, that tells us that we'll never be any good, that we're not worth it. It's so important that we listen to the voice of the shepherd. And what we hear there is that we are beloved. We are loved beyond measure, and we are invited to share in the abundance of life in a relationship with our Trinitarian God. St. Peter, in that first reading, is very clear. He tells the people listening to him, God has made this Jesus both Lord and Christ, Lord Kyrios, Lord of all creation, and Christ, the Anointed One, the Messiah, the one who came to redeem and sanctify, to forgive and to heal. And then he goes on to tell them what you must do is repent, metanoia, put on your highest mind, change your ways, let go of sin, and come to Jesus for forgiveness and healing. And then he says, you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Well, I think that those are the healing gifts of the Holy Spirit, who comes not just to forgive us our sins, but to heal us of our sinfulness, that which makes us sin, our painful emotions and our defects of character, and even our addictions. And then we can truly live that abundant life of peace and joy and freedom that Jesus wants to give us. In the second reading, again, it's from 1 Peter. And he reminds us there that Jesus bore our sins on the cross. He has come to forgive us so that we could live for righteousness, is what he calls it. That just another word, another expression for the abundant life that Jesus wants to give us. And in the psalm, we hear Jesus spoken of as the Lord is our shepherd. And with Jesus as our shepherd, we are given that banquet, that foretaste of that eternal banquet, the abundant life. We shall have no fear, even though we walk in the valley of darkness. He will give us green pastures. Today is also a day of prayer for vocations, a world day of prayer for vocations, or Vocation Sunday. On this day, we are especially asked to pray that the church may be provided with the leaders needed to do its work of spreading the gospel. Vocation means that God is calling me, vocare. It means to call, and has a plan for my life. And it is God's plan for my life that will allow me to bless the world with my life and meaning for ourselves. We can be inspired in these days by the frontline workers during this pandemic who are risking their lives to care for the sick and provide essential services for all. They have a sense that their work is more than just a job. It's really a call. And for them, we are deeply grateful. And so let us pray on this day that young people may likewise be inspired to give their lives in the service of others as priests and religious, and that young couples may have the faith and the courage to enter into the lifetime commitment of marriage as a sign of God's love for us, as marriage is also a vocation. The Eucharist that we celebrate begins with metanoia, with repentance, the penitential rite. We are aware of our need for God's forgiveness and healing, and that we receive. It's also a foretaste of the heavenly banquet, that the Good Shepherd provides for us. And especially in these days of spiritual communion, we listen to the voice of Jesus, forgiving us and healing us. And so as we celebrate today, let us pray that our faith will deepen in Jesus as Lord, as Messiah, as the Good Shepherd, and as the gate into the kingdom of God. Come to him for forgiveness and healing, and live in his kingdom of peaceful serenity, deep joy, and inner freedom in this life and all.